Okay, guys, so to start our lesson today, let's say a prayer, shall we? Amin. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, for the beginning, we are going to see a video. So enjoy the video. Not only enjoy actually, but also learn something on the video. So actually this is a listening section. And I have tips for you. If you want to, or if you will have a listening section, you need to be ready with think of, by thinking of what information that I need to catch up while listening. So guys, actually I have sent you a handout some hours ago on your WhatsApp group, so you may open up your handout. Here is the handout, guys. So in task one, actually there are 5 list question. Actually, this is these are a question that want to help you to listen to the video later. Yeah. So it's like a anticipation guide. Anticipation means apa ya? Antisipasi. Guide means petunjuk. How will you listen to the video? I mean, when you have a listening section, not all the dialogue are important. So you need to sift. Sift means dipilih-pilih. What information which is important? Yeah. So now let's discuss the question one by one first. Roy, help me to read question number one, please.
Okay, miss. Number one, how many persons are there in the video? Who are they?
Okay, so in the video, maybe you will see some participant, some person, some people. And then what you need to catch up is who are they and how many? And sometime you will easily find their name. So if you find clue in the video about a name, so you can answer this question by pay attention to the name. But sometimes the name is not available. If the name is not available, you may just say their role. Do you know what is role, guys? Not rules, yeah? Rules itu kan aturan. But this is role. The spelling will be R-O-L-E, role. Itu peran. Okay, in bahasa Indonesia we have peran. What are they role? Roles mean peran dalam dialog tersebut. As a listener kah? As a speaker kah? As a, maybe you will find some profession in the dialog. You may mention their profession if you cannot find a name. And then, wait, yeah, someone enter this room nih. Okay, number two, please, Aulia Xiang, read question number two.
Do you like the receptionist? Why?
Okay, first you need to answer the first question by yes, I do, or no, I don't. Yeah, and then tell us the reason why. If you like the receptionist, why? If you don't like the receptionist, why? So maybe there will be a receptionist in the dialogue. Yeah. So you have a clue in the second question. Number three, Angela Moliesta, please.
Do you think that the receptionist is an excellent?
Okay. Do you know what is excellent, guys? Okay, ini saya salah tulis ya. I have incorrect spelling. Ini harusnya excellent with T. Excellent. Do you know what is excellent, guys? Excellent is actually a level of quality. So in very low, low level, low itu yang paling bawah ya, the low level, the lowest level is poor. Poor is very bad. Yeah. After poor, you will have average, or sometimes you will directly to good. So poor, average, good. After that, you will have very good. After that, you have excellent. After that, you have perfect. So excellent is number two before perfect. Yeah. So in Bahasa Indonesia, we usually have sangat baik. Yeah, that's excellent. Do you think that the receptionist is excellent? You? Oh, berarti ini ada an di depannya, berarti benar excellence yang tadi, guys. Nah, yang seperti ini ada seorang yang sangat bagus berarti ya. And then ini, in this section you only need to answer by yes, I do, or no. No, I don't. Ya, yeah. Number four. Adriel, please.
Number four, in your opinion, what are the qualifications to be an excellent receptionist?
Okay, in your opinion. So it is based on your opinion. So there, this is open question. Open question, this means there are no fixed answer. So the answer will be free, yeah? Now, what is qualification, guys? Qualification. For example, if you find a job vacancy for lowongan pekerjaan, sometimes there are some qualification. For example, the qualification is 1 year experience in marketing, and then at least diploma study program, and then have one certificate. So what is qualification, guys?
Kriteria yang dibutuhkan.
Okay, criteria. What else? Okay, or maybe you want to be number one. To be number one, you must blah, blah, blah. Second, you must blah, blah, blah. So what is qualification? Selain criteria. Criteria, it's okay. But it has more specific Bahasa Indonesia. It's like persyaratan. Yeah? So in your opinion, what is qualification to be an excellent receptionist? Five. Herianto, please.
Find five vocabulary that specially used in Hotelier. Find.
Okay, ini hot karena vocabulary ini ada five, berarti jamak ya. Five vocabularies that specially used in Hotelier field. Jadi, what is vocabulary anyway? What is vocabulary?
Kosakata.
Yeah, kosakata. Jadi kosakata that only used in hotel. It means that you cannot find this vocabulary in medical field. What is medical? Medical means kedokteran, ya. you cannot find this vocabulary in engineering field. What is engineering, guys? Dulu title-nya insinyur kalau lulus. Sekarang MTeh. MTeh, STeh. Tehnya bukan teh, TEH ya, tapi tek.
Teknik.
Teknik ya, anak teknik. Jadi Anda nggak nemu kata-kata itu di anak-anak teknik gitu ya. Special vocabulary anak hanya untuk tourism and hotelier ya. So, now guys, you are ready with the idea what information should be catch up on the video. So now it's time for you to learn the video. Okay, I will play the video twice, yeah?
Good morning. Welcome to the Transnational Hotel. What can I do for you?
Good morning. My name is Tom Sanders. I have a reservation for a single room for 3 nights.
All right, Mr. Sanders, let me pull up your reservation. I can't seem to find a record of your booking. Did you book the room directly through us, or do you use a hotel reservation service or a travel agent?
Well, I booked it directly through you. I've already also paid a deposit on the first night. I have a reservation number, if that helps.
Yeah, sure. Can I see that, please? Thank you. Oh, I see. Maybe there was a glitch with the booking system. Well, we don't have any more single rooms available, with the exception of one adjoined room, but you would then be right next door to a family with children, which might get noisy. But that's not a problem. I can upgrade you to one of our business suites. They all come with jacuzzis.
Oh, that sounds nice. But how much more is that going to cost?
That would, of course, be at no extra charge to you.
Oh, well, thank you.
My pleasure.
What about the wireless internet?
Oh, it's really easy. This is your access code and instructions on how to use it. If you have any problems, feel free to call the front desk. And this is a list of all the hotel amenities, like the gym and the indoor pool.
Ah, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Has the valet already taken your car, or will you be needing a parking pass?
Oh, I don't have a car. I took a taxi direct from the airport.
Oh, all right. Could I have some form of ID, please? And could you just fill out this registration form?
Sure. Here's my driver's license.
Thank you. Oh, you're from San Francisco.
Yes, I am, all the way from the West Coast.
I hope you had a good trip.
Yes, I did. Thank you. The flight was long, but it was smooth, and I slept almost the whole way.
Oh, and is this your first time in the Big Apple?
Yes, it is. I have a business conference to attend, but I'm looking forward to getting some sightseeing done as well.
Well, I'd be more than happy to give you some sightseeing tips if you need any.
Thank you.
All right, I've got you all checked into your room. This is your room key. You're in room 653. Just take the elevator on the right up to the 6th floor. When you get off the elevator, turn right. Your room is at the end of the corridor on the left-hand side. Just leave your suitcase here and the bellboy will bring it up.
Great. Well, thank you very much.
If you need anything, please feel free to dial the front desk. Enjoy your stay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay. For anyone who has a problem with the video, please raise your hand with the raise hand facilities, yeah? For those student, tapi problemnya bukan karena cepat ya, emang durasinya normalnya segitu. Maksudnya videonya sometimes pause and have no voice and then no movement. Okay, from student who have a problem with the video, please raise your hand. Raise handnya pakai I can raise hand, ya. Okay, don't forget, you only focus, you need only to focus on the question tadi ya. So you need to gather means kumpulkan all information that are need to be discussed later, yeah. So after this, we will have discussion related to the video, and it's about our previous question. Those 5 question, yeah. And I hope all of them can participate on the discussion. Okay, no one have a problem, yeah? Gak ada yang raise hand. Berarti the second video I also will play here, yeah. Okay, the last video will be played. So here we go.
Good morning. Welcome to the Transnational Hotel. What can I do for you?
Good morning. My name is Tom Sanders. I have a reservation for a single room for 3 nights.
All right, Mr. Sanders, let me pull up your reservation. I can't seem to find a record of your booking. Did you book the room directly through us, or do you use a hotel reservation service or a travel agent?
Well, I booked it directly through you. I've already also paid a deposit on the first night. I have a reservation number, if that helps.
Yeah, sure. Can I see that, please? Thank you. Oh, I see. Maybe there was a glitch with the booking system. Well, we don't have any more single rooms available, with the exception of one adjoined room, but you would then be right next door to a family with children, which might get noisy. But that's not a problem. I can upgrade you to one of our business suites. They all come with jacuzzis.
Oh, that sounds nice. But how much more is that going to cost?
That would, of course, be at no extra charge to you.
Oh, well, thank you.
My pleasure.
What about the wireless internet?
Oh, it's really easy. This is your access code and instructions on how to use it. If you have any problems, feel free to call the front desk. And this is a list of all the hotel amenities, like the gym and the indoor pool.
Oh, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Has the valet already taken your car, or will you be needing a parking pass?
Oh, I don't have a car. I took a taxi direct from the airport.
Oh, all right. Could I have some form of ID, please? And could you just fill out this registration form?
Sure. Here's my driver's license.
Thank you. Oh, you're from San Francisco.
Yes, I am, all the way from the West Coast.
I hope you had a good trip.
Yes, I did. Thank you. The flight was long, but it was smooth, and I slept almost the whole way.
Oh, and is this your first time in the Big Apple?
Yes, it is. I have a business conference to attend, but I'm looking forward to getting some sightseeing done as well.
Well, I'd be more than happy to give you some sightseeing tips if you need any.
Thank you.
All right, I've got you all checked into your room. This is your room key. You're in room 653. Just take the elevator on the right up to the 6th floor. When you get off the elevator, turn right. Your room is at the end of the corridor on the left-hand side. Just leave your suitcase here and the bellboy will bring it up.
Great. Well, thank you very much.
If you need anything, please feel free to dial the front desk. Enjoy your stay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, that's all the video, guys. And now, how many person are there in the dialogue, guys?
Two.
2%. Okay, who are they?
Mr. Sanders.
Mr. Sanders.
Okay, you may say Mr. Sanders and the receptionist, or you may say the guest and the receptionist, or you may say the man and the girl and the woman. Okay, thank you. Next, do you like the receptionist? Maybe now I need you to share your opinion one by one. Anyone? Raise your hand, please. Anyone want to share their opinion? Okay, Aldi. Hello, Aldi. Yes, okay, do you like the receptionist? Waduh, no freeze. Aldi. Hello? Aldi! Hello, hello? maybe while we are waiting for Aldi, maybe we can go to another student, guys.
Saya, Miss.
Name?
Nafasya.
Okay, Nafasya, do you like the receptionist?
Sure, I like them because they are honest, friendly, they become company icons and really care about their appearance.
Okay, because she is very honest. What is honest, guys? Honest means jujur, ya? Yeah? And then friendly, what is friendly?
Ramah.
And then next, what is Nafa? Nafa? Friendly they and then?
Company icons and really care about the appearance.
Okay, really care about the appearance. Appearance in our campus is called what? Care about the appearance, namanya apa? Start from G.
Grooming.
Grooming. Okay. Good grooming or care about the appearance. Yeah. Okay. We have one opinion from Nafa. Any other? Any other opinion? Kayaknya tadi yang udah unmute udah banyak banget. Udah. Siap-siap pada mau ngomong semua tadi, saya kira mau rebutan. Okay, maybe Dwi Putri Yola Sari. Hello, do you like the receptionist? Do you like the receptionist?
I think yes, but yes. Little.
Why?
Yes,
it's
little.
What do you think about the receptionist? Pardon?
Oh, I think I like, but... Little-little gitu, dikit-dikit, nggak suka banget.
Okay. Well, what do you think about the receptionist? Is she beautiful?
Yes, beautiful.
Okay. Is she have a good smile?
Right, Miss.
Okay, thank you, Dwi. Next, please.
Welcome, Miss.
Thank you, Dwi Putri and then Nafa. Next, please. Two more students sharing their opinion. Okay, don't forget to always turn on the camera, yeah? How about Sabila? What do you think, Sabila? Do you like her?
Yes, Miss.
Okay, why?
She is beautiful. Terus juga ramah, terus tuh juga cara penyampaian dia ke laki-laki yang tadi tuh juga bagus gitu.
Okay. So if I can conclude what Sabila said, it's because the receptionist is beautiful and then friendly and have a good explanation to the guest. Is it correct, Sabila?
No, Miss.
Berarti apa? Salah dong saya ngertiinnya. Berarti gimana?
Iya, maksudnya iya, Miss. Sorry.
Have a good explanation ya. Cara menyampaikan kan ya. Menyampaikan means explained ya. Kayaknya tadi udah ada Aldi nih. Aldi, hello. How about you? Why do you like
yeah, Miss.
Why? Why you like the reception?
Karena.
It's because?
Karena. Because she's ramah.
Okay, what is ramah in English, guys?
Apa tadi, Miss?
Apa tadi, ayo?
Friendly.
Friendly. She is friendly. She is friendly. And dia apa ya, Miss? Dia bisa masuk. Mengikuti cara apa sih? Mengikuti dia gitu, Miss.
Mengikuti dengan
kayak ya, kayak bisa masuk gitulah ke obrolan
Okay.
Mister itu tadi.
She is friendly and she can, what is it? Can improve the relationship, yeah. She can improve the relationship between guest and receptionist, yeah. It is very important to build a more closer relationship between them, because a guest sometimes not only will visit our hotel one time, sometimes if they have a business matter, they will come to us regularly, maybe every month, maybe every year. And if we can maintain good relationship to our customer, they will have a good experience to our hotel, and then they will repeat to come our hotel. Okay, good. Thank you for your idea. And then next is, do you think that the receptionist is an excellent guy? Yes or no?
Yes, miss.
Yes, yeah. And then number four, in your opinion, what are the qualifications to be an excellent receptionist? Anyone want to share?
Can I share?
Okay, Roy. What is the qualification to be a good receptionist?
Yang pertama,
okay.
Menurut my opinion, the first, in the reception, we can solve existing problems when the guest room wants.
Okay, so you should, or we as a receptionist can solve a problem exists, yeah? If there are a problem, we can should directly solve the problem. Is it correct, yes, right? Okay, yes. And then?
The second, like before you say, miss, friendly dan bisa menyambut tamu dengan baik.
Okay, so I will have a resume. What is it? Conclude, yeah. Conclusion to your opinion. Yeah, wait. Excellent receptionist. First should be apa tadi ya? Friendly ya. Can respond to problem quickly. Okay. Any other opinion, guys? Thank you, Roy.
Saya, miss.
Name? Aulia Raffi Ashari. What is your nickname?
Aulia Raffi.
Okay, Aulia Raffi. How about
dipanggil Raffi. My opinion, you must always good in listening to people.
Okay.
And understand that there's need another generally enjoy talking to the guest.
Good listener, bukan listening ya, good listener, dia pendengar yang baik ya. Enjoy talking to the guest, and then one more tadi apa?
Understand there's need.
What the guest need, yeah?
Yeah.
Need, okay. To be a good listener, enjoy talking to the guest, and then understand what the guest need. Kalau kita rangkum nih, itu we can describe those in a one word. It means that she need to be helpful. Helpful ya guys, namanya itu perlu helpful. And then tadi, if I'm not mistaken, Roy said that she need to give a nice welcome. Yeah, okay, good. Okay, one more opinion, guys. Want to share their opinion? Rahayu, maybe. Kayaknya udah berlatih dari tadi ngomong, siap-siap mau berpendapat. Okay, Rahayu, please.
She is explaining in detail.
Yeah, very good. She can explain in details, and then okay, she can explain in detail. So she must be well informed, yeah, or you may say she must be knowledgeable. Knowledgeable means understand all information about the hotel, yeah. Okay, any more opinion?
Saya, Miss.
Your name?
Nafa.
Nafa, please.
Never asking for anything in return.
Pardon?
Never asking for anything in return.
Okay, never asking for anything in return. Okay, so tidak mengharap imbalan ya, tidak mengharapkan. So whether she or he do not busy thinking about tip that they will get, yeah. They will always give a good service whether or not the guest give them a tip or not. Jadi nggak membedakan guest yang kasih tip or nggak kasih tips, ya. Yeah. Never asking for anything in return, ya. Yeah. Okay. That's about qualification to be an excellent receptionist, ya. Yeah. Okay. Maybe I will add something, ya. Yeah. Maybe she or he must have a good grooming, good smiling, and also smart. Because if he or she do not smart, they can respond quickly to the problem, yeah? And also she or he must have a good attitude, yeah? Why good attitude is very important. Maybe if he or she do not have a good attitude, some example is they can playing with their cell phone while they are working. It's not good, yeah. Or maybe they talk to the guest while they are chewing a candy, yeah. Chewing means ngunyah-ngunyah, like chewing a candy, yeah. And then maybe they talk to the guest without having eye contact, yeah. So that's a bad attitude. So excellent receptionist must have a good attitude. Next, the last one is please find vocabulary that is special use in hotelier. From this question, I would like you to type the vocabulary in the chat box, ya. Jadi nggak usah dibilangkan, tapi di chat box, ya. Kayak Belia sudah saya accept, ya. Oke, silahkan tulis di chat box. Please write down in the chat box special vocabulary in hotelier field. I'll give you 1 minute. misalkan nemu satu, langsung aja ditaruh di chatbox ya. Misal Hanif misalkan nemu satu kata, langsung tulis di chatbox. Okay, good. Thank you, Maria. Book and reservation. The other, please. Okay, while waiting your chat, I need to go to toilet. Okay, time is up. Wow, banyak sekali. Okay, book reservation. Okay, good. Wait ya, ini maju mundur. Book reservation, a joint room, okay, good. Deposit, good. Room, check, okay, check in, check out, yeah. If it is more complete, kalau check aja. Any kind of field, use this vocabulary, yeah. But check in, check out is only special vocabulary for hotel and also airport, yeah. Okay, check in, check out, room service. Charge, extra charge, parking pass, booking, reservation, check-in, room key, okay, good, valid, okay, amenities, complimentary, okay, good, yeah, but it is not found in a video, yeah, jadi yang ada di video saja, okay, bellboy, driving license, everyone use driving license, yeah, not only everyone in a hotel, yeah. Extra bed, okay, good. Single room, business suite, registration form, and then elevator. It's not special, yeah, because everyone use elevator. Not only in hotel, yeah, but also in airport we have elevator. In hospital we have elevator, and in a mall we have elevator. Extra bed, good. Reservation, good. Jacuzzi, good. Check-in, travel agent, reservation, okay, double room, single room, taxi, no. Okay, yang ini amenities sudah, single room sudah, room service sudah, Room cleaner tadi nggak ada ya? Noisy is not special. President tadi nggak ada ya? Wake up all tadi, AK special tadi nggak ada di video. Okay, travel agent, good. Okay, gym is not special vocabulary. Yeah. Okay, that's what we call as jargon, guys. I will type this in a chat box. Jargon. So jargon here doesn't mean stiprum west. Stiprum should be the leader. Nah, bukan jargon yang seperti itu. It's not kind of a jargon, ya. Yeah. Jargon in linguistic, in linguistics mean ilmu bahasa, is special vocabulary used in a specific field. Field here means bidang. Bidang yang spesifik. For example, in hotelier we have upgrade, upselling, and then we have room rate, and then check in, check out. That's special vocabulary. It means that we cannot find those vocabulary in engineer, in medical, in chemistry, or what is chemistry? Kimia, and then in history or sejarah, tidak ada vocabulary itu. And as well as in medical, maybe we can find special vocabulary that we as a hotel or tourism person do not use that word. For example, injection. Kita orang pariwisata, orang hotel nggak ngomongin kata injection, but they have. And then bleeding or pendarahan, they have. Maternity, kehamilan, and there, apa lagi? Bed rest, they have. So once again, jargon is very special vocabulary. But this is the purpose or tujuan in using this jargon. It's not something about secret. Bukan ada maksud merahasiakannya. Karena memang tidak ada hal seperti itu di bidang tertentu. So that's what do we call it jargon. Yeah. And then talking about jargon, it's not always related to special field. Enggak hanya berhubungan dengan bidang tertentu, but also special community. On in bahasa Indonesia we have komunitas. Usually in the specific community they also have special vocabulary. For example, now Pak Rahmat Bahasa Indonesia lecturer and I now have a research about jargon used in a community of road bike in Jogja. It's called Spartan. Anyone join Spartan here? Ada yang join Spartan nggak di sini? So after this pandemic, new phenomena emerge means muncul ya, yeah? Muncul in our city, Yogyakarta ya, yeah? The phenomenon is a lot of people cycling or riding a bike, ya, yeah? After that they have new community, sepeda lipat itu ada sendiri, road bike ada sendiri, MTB ada sendiri, and we conduct the research especially for road bike community yang namanya Spartan. They have special vocabulary juga. For example, they have kewer. Ada yang tahu kata kewer itu artinya apa? Ini kata kewer itu orang lain nggak tahu. It's not because it is a secret, ya. Yeah. It's only because they need that vocabulary to talking in very short time and quick. Yeah. Kenapa mereka butuh quick and singkat? Because they discuss everything in a WhatsApp group. Yeah. And sometimes when they are meet. Yeah. So kewers mean itu keadaan ketika satu pesepeda itu tidak bisa mengimbangi pesepeda lainnya. Karena kalau baru bike road bike bersama-sama itu mereka banyak sekali ya. Dan nggak semua orang punya kecepatan yang sama. Yang dimaksud kewer itu adalah yang terengah-engah gitu ya, nggak bisa mengimbangi pesepeda yang lain, itu namanya kewer. Terus ada lagi contohnya, itu namanya jargon ya, jargon tapi di komunitas tertentu. Ada lagi SNI. Kalau kita SNI ya taunya standar nasional Indonesia ya, it means that that product has passed the standard of criteria in Indonesia, standard or qualification ya. But SNI in those community means sudah nanya istri. It means that they need to buy something very expensive related to their bike. Maybe they want to upgrade their bike or etc. So they have SNI means sudah nanya istri. That's about jargon, ya. Nanti di pariwisata sendiri pun ada istilah-istilah tertentu, like what we find in this video, like sightseeing. Nih, now we will discuss one by one about the some vocabulary happen in this video, ya. Okay, so let's.
Good morning. Welcome to the Transnational Hotel. What can I do for you?
Good morning. My name is Tom Sanders. I have a reservation for a single room for 3 nights.
Okay. Reservation itu juga only find in a ticketing ya. Not only in hotel sih, tapi in hotel juga. That's specific. That's special ya. If we have reservation itu berarti sinonimnya adalah okay, nanti kita ngomongin sinonim ya. Okay, reservation pemesanan ya.
All right, Mr. Sanders, let me pull up your reservation. I can't seem to find a record of your booking.
Ini jelas kan ya? Video sama suaranya? Ya,
jelas nih.
Semuanya ya, mantuk-mantuk.
Booking. Did you book the room directly through us, or do you use a hotel reservation service or a travel agent?
Well, I booked it directly through you. I've already also paid a deposit on the first night.
Okay, deposit. Deposit also special vocabulary. Deposit means we give, what is it, DP, yeah, down payment. It like a guarantee. Guarantee means jaminan. It's like a guarantee for us that we will surely go to that hotel. Yeah, some hotel need the deposit, but some of them not.
I have a reservation number, if that helps.
Yeah, sure. Can I see that, please? Thank you. Oh, I see. Maybe there was a glitch with the booking system. Well, we don't have any more single rooms.
Okay, single room is special vocabulary because they have a lot of kind of room, or generally they call as a room type. A single room, connecting room. Anyone want to share some type of room? We have single room, connecting room, and what are they? Angela, maybe you can share.
Apa, Miss?
Another type of room besides single room, we also have. Anyone want to share their experience about hotel? Octavia, can you mention another type of room?
Apa, Miss?
Can you share another type of room? Besides single room, we also have
twin
room. Okay, good. What else?
Business room.
Business room. What else?
Deluxe room.
Deluxe room. Okay. Actually, there are more than 5 room type, yeah. But we will have special meeting for discuss type of room, yeah. So let's go on.
Available with the exception of one adjoined room.
Now, one of them is adjoined room. Yeah. Joint room means this room beside another room. Usually we need this kind of room because we have special communication. For example, I need to go to a conference with my friends from Stipram, and we need to have some discussion, but maybe one of them a girl and one of them a boy, so that's why they cannot share the room, so that's why they have a joint room to easily connect it one to another. Tapi juga connecting room juga bahaya kalau boy and girl have a connecting room.
But you would then be right next door to a family with children, which might...
Now, one of them is family room, yeah?
Get noisy. But that's not a problem. I can upgrade you to one of our business...
Okay, upgrade you to one of business suite. Yeah, upgrade means we go to the next level of... what is it? Type of room. With more better facilities than before. Yeah, usually as a receptionist, they need to offer to the guests whether they need to upgrade their room or not. Or upgrade of room, upgrade of facility usually are given to the customer when the hotel doing a mistake. So it's kind of compensation or ganti rugi, or maybe it can be such a customer service. Yeah.
Business suites. They all come with jacuzzis.
How about jacuzzis, guys? Do you know what is jacuzzi? Jacuzzi. Anyone knows what is jacuzzi? It's like we bathing. Yeah, bathing. What is bathing, guys? Bathing mean mandi. Yeah. Tapi nggak hanya mandi, tapi we stay for a while in the water, or in bahasa Indonesia we have berendam. But the water not only contain a water, nggak hanya ada waternya di situ, but also with the bubble. Do you know what is bubble, guys?
Busa.
Ya, busa. Tapi busanya bukan busa yang dihasilkan from soap, ya, dari sabun, bukan, ya. But it's from air. Do you know what is air, guys? Air means udara. Jadi gelembungnya tuh bukan gelembung sabun, tapi gelembung kayak blubuk. Jadi it's like give us a soft massage to our body, ya. To make you clear understanding about jacuzzi, I think I need to share some pictures, ya, tapi bukan video orang berendam, loh, ya, jangan ngarep. Jacuzzi. Aduh, kok ada gambar orangnya semua. Wait. So this one is jacuzzi. So bubble is not made from the soap, but made from the power or the energy come from the air. Yeah, so it give you a soft massage on your body when you are bathing. Okay. This one.
Oh, that sounds nice. But how much more is that going to cost?
That would, of course, be at no extra charge to you.
Oh, well, thank you.
My pleasure.
What about the wireless internet?
Oh, it's really easy. This is your access code and instructions on how to use it. If you have any problems, feel free to call the front desk. And this is a list of all the hotel amenities.
amenities. Can you give me example of hotel amenities? Linda, can you give me example of hotel amenities?
Yeah, Bu.
Okay, can you give me example of hotel amenities? Or anyone can help Linda to give example of hotel amenities?
Bahasa Indonesia, Bu.
Example, do you know what is example, Linda?
Contohnya, Bu.
Yeah, example
seperti of kayak handuk sikat gitu.
Okay, towel and then toothpaste or toiletries. That room amenities. Okay, how about hotel amenities, guys?
Swimming pool.
Okay, swimming pool. Yang di bawahnya ada dia.
Wi-Fi.
Yeah, Wi-Fi. And then playground, yeah. Okay.
Like the gym and the indoor pool.
Oh, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Has the valet already taken your
car? How about valet? Okay, maybe I will play to you some another video. Yeah. Yeah, that telling you about valet.
As sly as a fox, as strong as an ox, as fast as a hare, as brave as a bear, as free as a bird, as neat as a word, as quiet as a mouse, as big as a house.
Nah, this one is valet. So what is valet, guys?
Pelayan.
Yeah, pelayan. Yang pelayan. Can you give me more specific of the this valet?
Little boy.
Bodyguard.
Okay, wait, yeah. I wanna be... I'll tell you the difference between valet and bellboy. So that's the bellboy. How about valet? So valet is someone that help you to park your car. Do you understand? So valet's job is to help you to park your car. So what all you need to do is just go to the lobby and then give your car key to the valet and then they will park your car, yeah. Jadi special tukang parkir in a hotel, yeah. Wait.
Please, and could you?
Or will you be needing a parking pad? Oh, I don't have a car. I took a taxi direct from the airport.
Oh, all right. Could I have some form of ID, please? And could you just fill out this registration form?
Sure.
A registration form, also special vocabulary used in hotelier, yeah? Because before we are checking in, we need to give some information related to our time of how many nights we will stay, and then our name, our contact person, and then what kind of special requests that we need to have, like morning wake up call, like.
Here's my driver's license.
Driving license itu cuma SIM ya, jadi itu bukan special vocabulary.
Thank you. Oh, you're from San Francisco.
Yes, I am, all the way from the West Coast.
I hope you had a good trip.
Yes, I did. Thank you. The flight was long, but it was smooth, and I slept almost the whole way.
Oh, and is this your first time in the Big Apple?
Yes, it is. I have a business conference to attend, but I'm looking forward to getting some sightseeing done as well.
Well,
and then we have sightseeing. What is sightseeing, guys? What is sightseeing, guys? Anyone knows what is sightseeing? Sightseeing. Ini istilah pariwisata ya. Atau mungkin saya perlu nulis ini dulu, besok kamus ini ya. Kamus pariwisata gitu. Sightseeing, coba. Pardon? Your name, please.
Penglihatan,
your name?
Muhammad Aldi Saputro.
Aldi tadi ya, oke. Penglihatan, oke. Sightseeing is an activity, guys. It's an activity of walking around. Do you know what is walking around? Walking around.
Lihat sekitar.
Ya, jadi walking around for the purpose is just see anything around us. Jadi tujuannya cuma see anything around us, cuma lihat-lihat aja. But we are walking around outdoor. Okay, itu namanya sightseeing. Okay, this is kind of tourism activity ya, because as what you have learned in tourism introduction, any kind of tourism has their purpose. For example, adventure activities. Sometimes you need to have sport in your activity when you are doing related to tourism. But sightseeing is another kind of activity in tourism. Yeah, it just have the purpose of seeing around. Yeah, but it will be different if it is happen in the mall. Kalau Anda lihat-lihatnya di mall, itu beda lagi namanya. You do not need to buy something, but just you just go to mall and then just see anything there. Namanya apa itu? That's we called as window shopping. Nah, itu namanya window shopping. Ke tempat orang shopping tapi cuma lihat-lihat nggak beli, itu namanya window shopping. That's a normal activity. Yeah, it's not. It doesn't mean that we have no money. No, just we maybe our purpose here is just maybe seeing something can motivate us. Yeah.
Well, I'd be more than happy to give you some sightseeing tips if you need any.
Thank you.
All right, I've got you all checked into your room. This is your room key. You're in room 653. Just take the elevator on the right up to the 6th floor. When you get off the elevator, turn right. Your room is at the end of the corridor on the left-hand side. Just leave your suitcase here and the bellboy will bring it up.
Great. Well, thank you very much.
If you need anything, please feel free to dial the front desk. Enjoy your stay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, that's all about new vocabulary we have found in this video. Yeah. Now I will, after we know all the new vocabulary, I need to give you an activity. This is an extra activity that give you a chance mean opportunity to give you deeper understanding about those new vocabulary. So here I will send you a link. Wait. So everyone please pay attention to the chat box. I have sent you a link. Please click the link by your own. Okay, if you click the link, klik sendiri loh ya, it will be like this one. So your task is, or what you have to do is, please find the synonym. Do you know what is synonym, guys?
Yes, miss.
Okay, explain please, what is synonym?
Persamaan kata.
Okay, it has different word, but it has the same meaning, yeah? Same meaning with the different word, yeah? Okay, you will find some of box here. Some box with the blue dot and some box with the orange dot. What you have to do is drag. Drags mean apa ya? Tumpuk ya. Drag the blue dot on the yellow, on the orange dot. For example, can you find the synonym of price? Okay, yang gampang aja. Can you find the synonym of facility? Maria, can you guess what is the synonym of facility?
Amenity.
Amenity. Okay, good. And then drag them here. Okay, until there is a connection, wide connection between the amenity and facilities. After that, you can check your answer by clicking this check mark, yeah? Now, if it is green, it means that this is correct. But if it is red, you need to repeat. It means that this is still incorrect. Okay, please do this on your own device. I'll give you 3 minutes. Or if you're done with your own, please raise your hand.
Miss, excuse me.
Hello.
I've done me.
Presentia, have you finished?
Yes, miss.
Okay. If you finish, you may write
to me, guys.
If you are finished, please raise your hand so we can continue to another activity. Okay, one more minute, yeah. Okay, time is up. So let us discuss. Carissa, do you have all green?
Yeah.
Okay. How about you, Fitria? Is all of them green? Fitria? Fitria?
Yeah, miss.
Okay. What happened to you? I cannot see you. Aulia, Devi, Adriel, Maldi, Sabila. And the other. What happened to you all, guys? Oke, sudah saya umumkan ya, dia mau pertemuan pertama setelah 15 menit, nggak on camera, tanpa keterangan ke toilet ataupun di chat box, saya berhak remove. So, let's hand in hand to make this semester successful ya. Okay, you may lower your hand now, guys. Let me go to Fitria. Okay, choose one of them, Fitria. Mau yang mana? Pardon? If you have a problem with your voice, you may type it in the chat box. Fitria. Write it down on the chat box. I cannot hear you.
Yang okay? Trip some trip itu sama dengan travel.
Okay. Trip with travel. Okay. And then next is Nathan?
Yeah, miss.
Choose.
Cost and price.
Cost and price. Okay, good. Next is Emma.
Bellboy to porter.
Okay, bellboy to porter. Next is Adriel.
Receptionist. Reserve.
Receptionist with reserve. What is reserve, guys? Coba ya, receptionist reserve. Let's check. Okay, red. Berarti belum.
What story, miss?
Pardon?
History.
History with?
Book. Eh, no. Front desk, maybe?
Front desk with?
Front desk.
With? Front desk with?
Receptionist, miss.
Yeah, front desk with the receptionist. Abel?
Upgrade with improve.
Upgrade with improve. Upgrade sering kita dengar ya. We can easily find the word upgrade on our cell phone ya. When we need to upgrade our some application, we get some notification that we need to upgrade. Yeah. Next is Shirley.
Yes, miss.
Aduh, ternyata sambil dengerin musik. Berarti you cannot hear my voice. And then, can you hear my voice when you
listening? Ada temen.
Can you listen to my lecturing while you are listening to the music?
Ada temen, Bu. Ada temen.
Di?
Satu kos.
Dalam kamar enggak?
Iya, Bu.
Oh, di dalam kamar minta dia keluar dulu. Masa kayak gitu banget sama temennya, udah tahu temennya kuliah.
Udah, Bu.
Oke. Okay. Choose, please, Shirley. Choose. 3 menit.
Book and available.
Book and?
Available. Available.
Cek Mbak di kampus Anda sekarang Mbak, available apa buku apa? Paling enggak mahasiswa ada aplikasi kampus di HP-nya.
Book and dari ini
harusnya dicari waktu tadi 3 menit saya kasih ini ya, kasih waktu. So guys, I apply task-based method. Saya mengajar itu pakai task-based, metode task-based. Jadi saya mengajar berpakai task. Task itu tugas-tugas. Tugasnya bukan tugas yang parah-parah, enggak. Seperti tadi Anda cuma membaca, seperti tadi Anda cuma menjodohkan. But the point is, by doing that those tasks, you experience something. Because it is impossible when we learning language without having experience. It is impossible in learning language, you only listen to me all the time. You need to experience by yourself. You need to experience how to listen. You need to experience how to deal with the vocabulary. You need to experience how to write, to read, and also how to write or how to speak, yeah. And because this is task based, between the one task to another task, they link each other. Mereka saling berhubungan. Jadi why you need to deal with this first, because we need to understand this vocabulary to go to the next task. Jadi next task impossible Anda bisa kalau Anda belum selesai tuntas di task sebelumnya. Okay. Maybe any other students want to help, please.
Book with reserve.
Available itu.
Inventory and record.
Ready, Miss.
Wait ya. Okay. Ini ya. Waktunya udah habis ya. Ada kuliah lagi setelah ini?
Gak ada, Miss. Okay. Habis ada kuliah lagi.
Sudah ya. Selesai ini top nanggung. Available sama?
Ready.
Ready. Okay. Good. And then?
Record sama
error sama glitch.
History.
Okay, history with
record.
We can find the word history on our YouTube and our Google search, ya. Makanya ada kata history di situ adalah record kita. Kita habis searching apa aja. And then the word error, kita tahu error dari glitch itu tadi di dial kata there is a glitch with our booking system, gitu kan ya, makanya bermasalah bookingnya. And then the last one,
reserve sama book.
Reserve and book, ya. Yeah. Okay, let us check. Okay, great. Okay, today we have 35 students coming to this lesson, guys. Let me check our semester. Total here we have 36 students, but why there are two students? Oh, ada two. Harusnya cuma satu yang nggak berangkat ya. Harusnya Daryl udah izin. Aulia. Aulia Raffi. Ada nggak Aulia Raffi?
Ada, Miss.
Oh, iya, iya. Aulia Raffi ada. Berarti the student who is absent today is only Daryl. Is it correct? Saya share ya, biar Anda lebih mantap ya. Nih, kelihatan ya. Berarti yang absent only Daryl. Oke, okay, mari masuk. Oke, okay, guys. For your information, if you cannot come to this session, you can come to my another class that is before your class. It means at 7 o'clock on Monday. It is H class, last H, bisa join di situ kalau pas jam Anda ada masalah. But if you cannot join both of them, you may join another lecturer. Jadi bisa join ke mana namanya dosen lain. But don't forget to ask for permission. Karena kalau yang nggak ada permission, nggak akan di-accept biasanya. So please ask for their permission first and then be nice. Why? Because if you are not nice, they will text me. Bu, mahasiswamu, nana. Kayak gitu. So please make sure be nice and have their permission. And after that, have a record. I mean, give me a proof that you are on their class. Itu biasanya kalau saya ada nggak tahu proofnya apa, bukti bahwa Anda udah join mereka, and then saya juga akan konfirmasi ke dosennya. Do you have any question, guys, for today? Okay, actually ini tadi ada listening-nya lagi ya, ada dua lagi. Thanks sekali, nggak nyampe waktunya. And why nggak nyampe waktunya? It's because I think you need be more cooperative, guys. Tolong lebih kooperatif. It is impossible this class will be successful if it is only me that do my effort. But I need your help to do your best when you join my class. Ya, yang namanya Angga dari tadi off cam. Next time I'll remove you if you do this again. Okay. Okay, see you guys. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Terima kasih, Bu.
Assalamualaikum.
Terima kasih, Mi.